A murder suspect who spent the past 12 years on the FBI's most wanted list is behind bars in Maryland. 53-year-old Jorge Landeros is accused of killing American University professor Sue Markham. Police spent more than a decade tracking him down, and tonight he's back in Maryland to face justice. Our Leslie Marino joins us live at Montgomery County Police Headquarters, where investigators just revealed new details about this case. What are we learning, Leslie?
Yeah, guys, investigators briefed us about an hour ago. Landeros is being charged with first-degree murder. He's currently being held without bond. If he's convicted, he could potentially spend the rest of his life behind bars. We're also just learning Landeros was working as a yoga instructor in Mexico under a different name when he was arrested last year. The state's attorney says Sue Markham had a life insurance policy for $500,000. Landeros was listed as a beneficiary. He was also investing her money. We're told Landeros is accused of killing Markham in the basement of her home in Bethesda. In 2010, Landeros fled to Mexico, and after 12 years, local authorities were able to arrest him in Guadalajara, Mexico. This was in December. Authorities obtained a DNA swab from Landeros, linking him to Markham. The state's attorney says the cause of death, blunt force trauma, and asphyxiation. This arrest has been a long time coming for Markham, family, the FBI, and Mexican authorities.
It is my understanding that Ms. Markham's family is watching this news conference online. I want to send my gratitude to them for their patience as we work to locate and extradite Mr. Ruida Landeros. I hope that this arrest, and knowing that he is back in Montgomery County to face trial, will provide some closure, some sense of closure to you all.
And Landeros is expected back in court on August 19th. We'll be sure to follow up with the story both on air and online. For now, reporting live in Montgomery County, Leslie Moreno, WUSA 9.
We are thinking of Sue Markham's family tonight. Leslie, thank you.